CBOXINGINFO TV. I'm your host, Chris Williams, and we're truly delighted that you've joined us for our very first show. Today, we're going to take you down south to beautiful Raleigh, North Carolina, and introduce you to a fighter by the name of Donnell Holmes. Holmes is an American heavyweight with a record of 31-2, but for some reason, he's unable to land the big fight. Holmes truly has an interesting story, but instead of us telling it to you, why don't we allow him to do it? Ladies and gentlemen, Donnell
Holmes. Every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling.
Who am I? Why do you ever heard of me?
I'm basically trying to take care of him, support him, and set up some things for him and his family.
little bit about the feels. It feels like I have a little bit of a lot of love around the feels of the hard life. And I'm hoping I can share something sensitive about the feels. But, you know, with my boxing career, I've been able to have 10% from day one. And I've always told me and my staff, and it just haven't worked out that way. I finally got a shot, which he's nobody, but his name is known. So that was the real reason that we took the fight, you know, we got a name known. And I hope it would step me into a position to get something off of him, or at least get some attention from my name. And the fight was just as planned, you know, 6 weeks before the fight. I actually had to ask him if I was scared of him and all the other things, just to secure the fight. Because I didn't want them to see where he's too confident and take him out of the fight. So every interview I did, I wasn't ashamed to act as if I was worried about losing the fight. I just didn't have confidence out of the fight. So, you know, I know I haven't fought anybody as good as him. Because I wanted them to be overconfident and confident, because they didn't know me. And so the night before the fight, my exact words were to do it, but I asked me, how did I feel the fight was less than 24 hours away? What did I do different to prepare? Hey, he's a bitch. His name should be the bitch Pinto because he's just a butter. You know, how can you call yourself a professional fighter when as soon as you get into a tough fight, the first thing you do, if it's not some dead meat they brought in, somebody's actually fighting back for blood pressure and a pulse, you quit. You look for a way out. That's the way, that's the bottom line. And actually, I'm down to lose the weight now, and you're one of the reasons I'm down. You can't run and hide for help.
I've always wanted to fight the top guys. These fights have been awful. I've been after these
guys trying to get the fights. They're either they're scared or the promoters, but somebody, for some reason, it never happened. Why wouldn't a heavyweight with a 33-0 record get a meaningful fight? I would have wanted to win the NABA title in the heavyweight to secure my rank and into the cruiserweight division and open the door wide open, let everybody know that I'm here. I've come, I'm here, and I'm ready to make all the challenges. Because big, sorry heavyweight don't want to fight this one guy in the division. And they all call a boy with a built record. So I've been forced to try out to lose 25 pounds to come down to cruiserweight. Because at least in cruiserweight, these guys are athletic. They have a weight limit that they have to meet. So that means they do have to train some. And you got, it's a lot of opportunity that you still have. Not only the four champions, but you have Bernard Hopkins. He's floating around that weight class. You have Roy Jones, he's floating around that weight class. You have Danny Green from Australia, just beat Gordon. He's around that weight class. You have Antonio Tower. You have all these guys that got big names that are still in circulation. James Tooney may even want to come back down and do it. I'm open for all challenges, but I'm naming guys that will fight good fighters. Not just talk about who, how good they are. They actually challenge another fighter. And then you have the champions. Plus, most of the guys in the cruiserweight division are the guys that I fought in the light heavyweight division as amateurs. So a lot of them I'm already fought and were familiar with. You have the weight class of guys that I beat already in the amateur. If I could have my way, when I was fighting, when I first started off, and I was fighting once a month, I was at my best. Because I was sharp, I stayed in shape, you fight, take a couple of days off, relax the first week, you work back in easy, and then you have a couple of decent work weeks, and you're right back in the gym. As long as you don't have an injury, that's the way I like it. So my goal would always be to do something no heavyweight or no cruiserweight champion have ever done. To win the title, I would take 1 month off to kiss babies, meet and greet, go around, and let everybody know who Donnell Holmes is. And the next 10 months of that year, I would fight the top 10, number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, up to top 10. And after that, you know, that year, I would retire. I've had to pay travel and food and everything out of that. My trainer lives 30 miles outside of Raleigh. He drives faithfully every day to Raleigh, 30 miles in one way, to come train at the time that I call him. Because he know how my schedule is, because trucking, traffic, appointment delays, getting loaded, getting held up, stops, and everything. So the thing about it is, thank God he retired, he's flexible, but he comes with me. He haven't got anything out of it. I've been some of the fights I was in. He's had to pay for my food. He's had to pay for my license. He had to pay for things for me. And he's my dreamer. But that's another thing somebody God said in my path. Because he believes in me. He see I'm not that vulnerable. He believes in doing the right thing. Eventually my time is going to come. If I make it, if I made it $1 million fight, I'm not saying, well, I'm going to make it big. But the first $1 million fight I make, everybody that I got is going to get touched from there. I may end up like MC Hammer, but I wouldn't end up like MC Hammer because I'm trying to help everybody that's my friends or my homeboys. I would end up broke because I help everybody that helps me along the way.
Donnell, that was truly amazing stuff. And we at CBOXING INFO TV hope that you get your shot at either a heavyweight or a cruiserweight title. On a side note, Holmes was recently offered a fight against up-and-coming European heavyweight Tyson Fury on Showtime. For some reason, Holmes had to turn down that fight. We were able to acquire a letter that Donnell sent to Mick Hennessy, actually rejecting the fight. We'll actually post that on our website and allow you to take a look at it. In boxing, opportunities only come once in a lifetime. And hopefully for Holmes, that wasn't his once in a lifetime. Folks, thank you again for joining us today at CBOXING INFO TV from beautiful Raleigh, North Carolina. Next week, we'll be in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada, covering the Uriokas Gamboa Orlando Salido fight. So remember, keep your hands up, protect yourselves at all times, and for CBOXING INFO TV, I'm Chris Williams.